Hi, it's Dwyer, gamblersadvisory.com, dwyervip.com for premium picks. Look us up in the sports section on Roku, we're there. Dwyer Boxing and Sports News. Remember, the opinion you should follow should be your own. Just consider this video to be a second opinion from a complete stranger online. Now, in my other life, when I'm not in front of the camera with my pet, talking about boxing and boxing picks, I'm actually a lawyer. And in my practice, I have been before the California State Athletic Commission in a prior legal matter. Right? I know some of the players. I know what the experience is like. Let's talk about what's being reported incorrectly right now by media outlets, including a very well-intentioned BoxingScene.com. Now, Robert the Ghost Guerrero, full disclosure, I'm in Northern California. The Ghost is a hero here, right? He's one of this area's best fighters, right? By the way, you need to keep an eye on Northern California, right? Because you got a few fighters up here. Now, you know, Denier, Andre Ward. Look at the work Virgil Hunter is doing. He now has added people like Amir Khan to his stable. Then you realize that Robert the Ghost Guerrero is up here as well. We're holding it down here in Northern California, right? Kareem Mayfield. Well, understand that Robert Guerrero has had enough of Golden Boy, right? There's politics involved in boxing. Sometimes being with a big promotional company isn't the move you want, because it's like being with a big corporation. They view you as client number 6 or 16 or 60, right? You're not getting the special attention that you might get from, let's say, a boutique promoter who is focused on, you know, you as their main client, right? So Robert Guerrero wants to test his market value. He wants to venture away from Golden Boy. And he made some interesting arguments in the request for arbitration that he filed before the California State Athletic Commission. Now, make no bones about it. Robert Guerrero is a resident of the state of California, right? So he turned to his local commission and he said, look, the contract that I signed, the extension, violates California law, right? If there's anyone who should be protected by the California State Athletic Commission, it should be one of California's finest boxers, right? Take a look at this contract. Contracts are supposed to be limited to 5 years. It's illegal to sign, you know, a further extension. But of course, that's what happened here. And Guerrero's point was simply, look, this extension is illegal, right? He had another point. There's a choice of law provision apparently in his agreement. It says a New York choice of law. Guerrero's point is that everyone in the room knows he's a California fighter. He should be entitled to the statutory protections afforded him in California. This New York choice of law provision is unenforceable. Now understand, the California State Athletic Commission looked at the choice of law provision and decided that they were not going to reach the merits of the case. Their point is simply, you're a well-paid boxer. You were represented by a legal team when you signed this contract, right? This contract says that the place for you to resolve any dispute is in New York State, not California. You can't forum shop. No one held a gun to your head when you signed this contract that said that any disputes arising from this contract should be tried in New York, not California. So all the California State Athletic Commission ruled was that they were the improper venue for this dispute to be heard. Right? Their argument is simple. We don't have jurisdiction. Why? Because you negotiated away our jurisdiction. Right? The agreement's not silent on who has jurisdiction. The agreement says, apparently, that New York has jurisdiction, not California. So, of course, the message from the California State Athletic Commission is, look, you have the right to negotiate which forum has jurisdiction, right? We'll protect you if you leave jurisdiction with us. But if you sign an agreement that says that some other place has jurisdiction and not us, then you can't later come back to us and say, rule on this contract. The contract I signed that says New York has jurisdiction. So understand, the ruling is procedural. It's not on the substance of the claims, right? They're not saying anything about whether Guerrero is right about the facts. They haven't made a ruling on that. The California State Athletic Commission has specifically said, we're not making a ruling on the substance of the claims. All they have said is, you file this request for arbitration in the wrong place, right? And so the bad blood continues between Robert Guerrero and Golden Boy, right? To the extent that Guerrero's claims are based on California law, he's going to have to revise those claims. Because what California is saying is, our law doesn't apply to a contract you signed that says it needs to be interpreted under New York law, right? This, for law school students, is called choice of law, right? And so don't get carried away when you read that the commission ruled against Robert Guerrero. It didn't rule against Robert Guerrero's legal claims, other than to say we aren't the proper place to hear them. That's it. So I'm guessing Robert Guerrero and his legal team's going to sit down now and look at New York law, right? This is a big choice of law dispute. And they're going to figure out how to reframe their arguments to fit New York law. Right? That's what's going to happen. Right? Maybe Richard Schaefer and the people at Golden Boy are going to sit down and try to negotiate some kind of settlement, try to address some of Guerrero's concerns. Right? Maybe a resolution is possible. Maybe all parties can actually agree on the future course of Guerrero's career. But, right, and this is serious, Golden Boy has to realize that one of their best fighters, let me repeat that, one of their best fighters is unhappy. And they're going to have to be more responsive to his needs. Quite frankly, boxers have a very short career span, right? They need to take care of themselves. This is prize fighting. They need to keep their eye on the prize. If they feel that the people around them are not allowing them the best opportunities available, then they need to take steps. All I want you to know is don't look at the California State Athletic Commission and its ruling as anything other than a procedural ruling. They have not determined that Robert Guerrero was treated fairly. Right? They have not determined or ruled upon the enforceability of certain provisions in the agreement, right? They haven't done so. All they have said is, we're the wrong place. You've chosen New York law. I guess they have upheld the choice of law provision. That's it. They haven't made any other ruling. You shouldn't read too much into the ruling other than that Robert Guerrero requested arbitration in the wrong forum? Let me hear from you. Leave your comments for me here online. Visit us at gamblersadvisory.com and understand it is important because, of course, media outlets need to know who to negotiate with to get Robert Guerrero to appear on their fight cards. Right now, it's unclear whether Guerrero wants Golden Boy negotiating on his behalf. Food for thought. All right, I see my girls are about to come in here. Let me sign off. Thanks for stopping by.